Hello viewers, and welcome back to the Card Mat. Nice one here by Frank Garcia, and it's only using 9 cards, 8 of which are the same and 1's different, and we'll call that the wild card. As you can see, I've got a 5 of spades there, which I'll deal onto the table, and I'll put another 5 of spades on the top of it. I'll deal another 5 of spades onto the table and put another 5 of spades onto the top of that. I'll deal another 5 of spades onto the table, put another 5 on there. I'll deal another 5 onto the table and put another 5 onto there. That brings us down to the wild card. Now I'll take the joker and pick up the first 5, put them square into my hand, give them a tap and a click, flip it over and give it a wobble. I can actually turn that first 5 into a joker. In case that was too quick, I'll show you it again. Take the 5 and the joker together, put it in my hand, give it a click and a tap, turn it over, pass it through my hand and flap it around. We find that that 5 has turned into a joker. I'll show you again with this one, but I'll do it a bit different. If I put it into my hand and give them a bit of a flipping over, we find that in the flipping motion, it actually causes that 5 to turn into another joker. I'll show you it again, and I'll do this one a little bit different again. If I put it into my hand, give a click, pass it through like that and a little spin, we find that that actually causes that 5 to turn into another joker. Right, now I want to draw your attention to the fact that all these cards have got backs. As you can see, the 5 at the top's got a back, and that joker on the bottom's got a back. So if the joker on the bottom, well, on the top there had a back, I can put that down. I can show you that the middle joker has a back, and the bottom card has got a back, but it should have been the 5. Anyway, I'll show you that again. The 5 on the top's got a back, and the joker on the bottom's got a back, so I can turn that one over and put that down. So I can show you that the middle card also has a back, and that the bottom card, which was the 5, is now a joker and also has a back. Let's try it again. 5 on the top's got a back, turn it over, you can see that the joker on the bottom's got a back. So I can get rid of that joker and show you that the middle joker also has a back, and that the bottom card is a joker again and also has a back. Last time, it's got to be the last time, it's the last packet. Card on the top's got a back, the card on the bottom's got a back. So I can get rid of that card, put that down. So I can show you that the middle card has a back to it, and the bottom card, which again should have been a 5, is now a joker and also has a back. Right, Well, I hope you enjoy. I've got more jokers than I know what to do with now. I don't know. Well, I hope you enjoyed that. If you'd like to see a tutorial for it, stay where you are. Well, I hope you enjoyed that little performance of Wildcard by Frank Garcia. I just think his handling on that's really, really good. Fantastic. So, here's how it goes. I'll go through the cards from the bottom of the deck, a face-up deck, but from the bottom. Right, on the bottom you have a normal joker, and then another normal joker, using 9 cards by the way. Then you have a joker on the back, and whatever cards you can get with a joker on the back, it's usually 5 of spades or 5 of clubs, they're very limited in what you do. So you have your gaffer with the 5 facing up, then you have another regular joker, then you have another gaffer, then you have another regular joker, then another gaffer, then another regular joker, and finally a gaffer on the top. So it looks like you've got 5 joker, 5 joker, 5 joker, 5 joker, 5 joker, joker. And all the face-up jokers are genuine. Right, so you start off with them all squared up. I say you're going to show a trick using just 9 cards, 8 of which are the same and 1's different, and you'll come to that one in a bit. And all you do is get hold of it, because you're going to do a glide. So all you're doing is you're sliding that top card down a bit. But you do that as you're turning your hand over, because you go, look, I've got a 5 of spades there. And as you're turning your hand over, you just do the movement so it's not seen. Because if you turn it over and then do it, you see the little spread of the fingers. So you do it as you're turning your hand over. And then you just pinch the sides of the pack pretty stiff to stop any other card sliding up. As you pull out that first joker, and I'll put a 5 down, then put your first finger on the top and just push it down so it squares the pack up again as you turn over, and go, I'll put a 5 on the top of it. Then you turn over and again you do a glide. So all you do is just, as you're turning over, pull that top bottom card down, slide out the second to bottom card, say I'll deal a 5 down, square them up again as you turn them back, and I'll put a 5 on the top. Then do the glide again. I'll try and show you what the glide looks like from this angle. If you're doing that, and then you're just pulling that card out, and you're just pushing and squaring that up. As you deal that one down, saying that's another five, and you put another five on the top of that. You turn over again, do another glide, slide out another joker, square it up as you're turning over, and you put a five on that. Brings us down to the wild card, which just happens to be a joker. Now, when you're doing this, make sure that all your jokers are all facing the same way. You know, there's none which are upside down, if you know what I mean. Make sure they're all the same way. You go, right, if I take the first five and you just scoop up face down cards in any pile you want to, scoop it up, put it into your hands, say, if I just get hold of it, give it a tap, give it a wobble, give it a click, get a monkey to dance around, whatever you want to say, just biff them about and turn it over to show it's turned into a joker. So you go, blah, 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 and you see that the first five, and say it, do it like this because it takes the emphasis off. Because you're doing a Mexican turnover, but it looks a bit off. Because you're putting two face down, two face up cards, and then you're coming away with a face up and a face down, if you know what I mean. That's your gaffer, innit? So you want to be going, so you can see that the first five has turned into, and as you turn it over, you point out and say, a joker. So it looks more normal. Then you go, if you think, in case I've done that a bit too fast, and again, you're just scooping up another face down card. So I'll do it again. If I give a tap and a click and give it a wobble and dance a monkey, whatever, flap around, you see that that five has also turned into a joker. I'll show you it again, but I'll do this one a bit different. And again, you're just scooping the card up. A lot of it is repetition. Pick it up. And if I just give it a couple of flip overs in a hand, give them a flap together, we'll see that that five has also turned into a joker. I'll show you it again, but again, I'll do this one a little bit different. So if I give it a tap, a click, and pass it through. And if you're doing a pass through, when you pass it through, make sure you spin it back around again, so the jokers end up back the same way. Because if you just do a push through like that, they're going to be upside down. So if you do the push through, make sure you put a spin on it to pull it the right way. Give it a flap, and do the exact same thing with that one. Then you say, I want to draw your attention to another fact about these cards, and that's they've all got backs. So see, I've got the five on the top, but you can tell it's the five because there was a five and a joker down there. So I've got the five on the top, it's got a back, and then turn them all over, and you just pull, doing a pinky pull down on your bottom card. I say, and that top one's got a back, so I can take that top one and put that down. I can show you then that the middle one has a back, because you've just got rid of your gaffer. The middle one's got a back. And at the bottom one, which should have been a five, also has a back. I'll say that again, and again, you just scoop them up the same way. Do whatever moves you want to do, showing that there's a back on that side and a back on that side. Again, you get a pull down on the bottom card to do a double lift. Dealing the top card, which is your gaffer. Showing the middle one's got a back. And at the bottom one, which again should have been a five, has a back. You do it again with this one. Pick it up. That side's got a back. And that side's got a back. Do a pinky pull down, flip it over. That one's, you can get rid of that one to show that the middle one has a back, and the bottom one, which again should have been the five, has now turned itself into a joker. You do it one more time. I mean, if you can think of any other way of doing this bit instead of being so repetitive, do it. I'm just doing this exactly the way he done it. So you just scoop that up. See, there's a back on that side, and again, there's a back on that side. Again, you do a double lift, turn over and say, so we can get rid of the top one because we know that's got a back. And we can see the middle one's got a back. And the bottom one, which again should have been a five, also has a back and is now a joker. It's not hard to do. The hardest part is getting all your gaffers together. Because they... As I say, you don't really get them with five of spades or five of clubs on them. You can make your own if you've got the time. I just didn't have the time, so I went out and bought them. And it works out well. So I hope you can have fun with that one. And I say it's not hard. Have fun with it. You can get the cards or make the cards. You can, if you want to, glue. That would have been a good idea, wouldn't it? Showing it that way. Glue two cards together. As long as it's a brand new pack, the cards won't get too thick. I mean, already it's double the size of a normal card, but you know what I mean. You can do it that way. Anyway, shut up. Go and have fun. I'll see you again later.